called Clive Barrett.
They didn't have time to do anything. And I saw them there, frozen, hands in the air. And I think I heard one of them say something like, "Don't shoot, boys."
Don't shoot, boys?
Yeah. And then they just started shooting. And the soldiers went up to them and kicked the bodies, you know. Saw one of them shoot one of them again in the head 3 times.
As he lay on the ground?
On the ground, yeah.
Freeze it there.
PC Barrett was the nearest witness.
Apart from the SAS, he's the only person who would know if proper warnings were given.
I've never seen this clip before.
Neither had we. It's a 6-part series on shoot to kill all around the world. Covert operations, disappearances, wherever the state sidesteps the rules. Episode 4 is the one which deals with Brighton.
It's a bit contentious, isn't it? How do you decide where law enforcement ends and shoot to kill begins?
The SAS rules of engagement for the military commander in Brighton were quite clear. They were there to assist the police in arresting the terrorists. They were not to use more force than was necessary and were to give a clear warning before opening fire. The terrorists were unarmed. I'm sure you remember. The government was not at its most popular, and the party was screaming for blood. Then the shootings. 6 percentage points in the polls, standing ovations all round. Enough jingoistic headlines to sink the Belgrano all over again.
Mm. Best news the Home Secretary had all year. Stopping the IRA from carrying out a rerun of 1984.
That's the official line. PC Barrett was not called at the inquest. The hotel security cameras had been switched off 3 minutes prior to the shooting, so until that home video surfaced, we didn't even know there was a police officer present at the scene.
How did you get hold of the video?
It arrived in a brown envelope. We've had a lot of cooperation on this one from Special Branch.
And who was it recommended me?
Maureen. I'm a journalist. Don't ask me to divulge sources. I'm interviewing a Special Branch officer. Naturally, he can't be identified.
Why do you think Special Branch is so keen to help a documentary on shoot to kill?
Sour grapes? MI5 took over anti-terrorist work from Special Branch soon after the Brighton incident. Well, it was going that way before, but Brighton clinched it for MI5. So, Branch led me to PC Barrett, but he's not keen to appear in the programme. I was hoping that with your experience of getting coppers to confess, you might stand a better chance of persuading him.
He saw the shootings and then kept quiet for 2 years?
Yes.
So he was sat on?
I'd say so.
And now Special Branch have led you straight to him?
Something like that. As far as I'm concerned, Brighton was a clear case of shoot first and don't ask questions later. But it'll sound better coming from PC Barrett's lips.
Kate.
Oh, hello, Tony.
Is Mum about?
No.
Oh. Job hunting, I suppose.
No, she's got a job.
Got a job already?
Yeah, she's working for a TV company.
What's she doing?
Some sort of investigation. She's had to go down to Brighton. Look, you can come in if you like, but I'm a bit late meeting a client for lunch.
No, it's all right, it'll wait. Thanks. You better take this. Just tell her it was to celebrate new opportunities.
Right.
Why was everyone so edgy?
Word had got round they were mixing Brighton. It was the Tarks gearing up for the party conference. They're always good for gossip.
So you had information from prostitutes that there were terrorist suspects in Brighton?
I didn't say terrorists. I said mix. We were all on alert.
Did you see the incident very clearly?
What I saw was 3 men jump out of cars and shoot the living shit out of 3 paddies. I mean, they could have been gangsters, armed robbers. I didn't know. I thought this is it. End of the line. Burial with full police honours.
I've had those moments myself. You're in shock for days, I know. And you see the world differently afterwards.
I actually spoke to two of them. They drove up in their car. I told them they couldn't park there. They drove off. We were on the alert, listening out for Irish accents, so I radioed in, reported the two of them. 5 minutes later, I see them walking down the seafront, and the third one, Kelly, he walks up to them. Next thing, it's Bosnia. Bullets flying.
Did you hear any warnings before the SAS opened fire?
Maybe I did. Maybe I didn't.
They must have asked you at the inquest if you heard a warning.
I wasn't at the inquest.
You weren't?
Well, it wouldn't have made a bit of difference if I was.
What makes you say that?
Come on. You've got an active service unit in the streets of Brighton planning to blow up the Tories. There was no way I was going to stand in that witness box and say I heard no warnings.
Take your point. Did you ask to avoid giving evidence?
I didn't have to. It was all looked after.
How do you mean?
Special Branch told me to keep my head down. Otherwise, my fellow officers might forget to help me out when I'm in the shit. I didn't need to be told. I didn't want to rock the boat.
Well, that's fine. What you've just told me is all we want to hear from you. Would you be willing to repeat it on camera?
I plan to do another 15 to 20 years in this job, Maureen. I'm not going to appear on TV and break the earth-shattering news the SES got trigger-happy.
Well, what about the prostitutes? Would it be worth me talking to them?
You could try. But I didn't tell you.
Pamela Hewitt. Where will I find her?
In Brighton.
Barrett's not going to talk. He's got too much to lose if he does.
Well, that leaves a nice big hole in my programme.
He did say that a local
prostitute had tipped him off about Irishmen in Brighton. I don't know where that might lead us.
It's worth following up. Can you find her quickly?
Yeah, okay, but I'll need to bring in someone to help me.
Fine. Keep me posted.
Right.
Why'd she ring you and not me?
I don't know, Gov. Suppose she thought I was better qualified.
Maybe she thought I was busy doing another job, huh? She ask about me?
No.
Oh. Well, thanks for mentioning me, Harry. Here I am trying to get the old firm together and you two are sneaking off and do a job of your own.
Well, I'm sorry, Gov. I've got a train to catch.
You're saying that MI5 told the SAS that the terrorists were armed?
Yes.
And that there was an explosive device in the vicinity?
Yes.
And that information was wrong?
Not exactly. The van was loaded with Semtex.
But there were no detonators?
No.
It does appear that whilst Special Branch were responsible for the safety of government ministers at the conference, you were bypassed by Cabinet Office and MI5 when it came to the terrorists.
It was MI5's show.
But at that time, it was Special Branch's job to provide and assess intelligence about Irish Republican terrorism in Great Britain. Why were you left out of the equation?
Under the 89 Act, MI5 comes under the authority of the Home Secretary. There was a direct line between Cabinet Office and MI5 officers on the ground.
And those officers are not accountable?
That is correct.
If MI5 gave misleading or inadequate information to the SAS, might they also have misinformed Cabinet Office?
You'd have to ask them that.
Do you think, then, that Cabinet Office chose MI5 and the SAS to neutralize a perceived threat because they're unaccountable?
Yes.
Harry, I want to get something clear. I've got a job, there's a problem, and I need your help. But that doesn't mean it's the old firm back in business, because it's not. It's my case, and I'd value your expertise. That's all. So I don't want any cosy old boys chat about the job. I'm out of the police. That's it. It's over. Okay?
Right. And I'm on 100 quid a day, plus expenses.
Huh. Maybe you can tell me why Special Branch told Barrett to keep quiet about the shootings, and then send a TV company after him 2 years later.
No, I can't.
This is the spot.
You know, in my day, this sort of thing used to happen in A-sheds in the middle of Armagh. I bet there was a lot of tea spilt round here that morning. Right, where do I start?
Yes, sir.
Double scotch, please, love.
Ice.
No.
£4, please.
How much?
£4.
I'll have her a seat and all, please.
Thank you.
Sorry to bother you. I'm looking for someone.
Not here.
No, please. I need information on somebody. Her name is Pamela Hewitt. Can you help?
You down here for a day or two?
Nah, just an hour.
All in your own?
Yeah.
Where's your missus?
I ain't got one.
No? You look like a married man.
I was.
I'm sorry.
That's all right. That's the way it goes, isn't it?
Brighton can be a lonely place if you're on your own.
Yeah. I'm looking for a woman called Pamela Hewitt. You don't know her, do you?
Called Kenny Bates. Usually drinks in the Mariners.
What were you waiting for then?
Apparently he's a bit of a head case.
Great.
Come on then, tired gentlemen, please. Let's have those glasses. Kenny, phone call, mate. Come on, let's have those glasses. Haven't you got homes to go, Trent?
Yeah?
Kenny, I want to talk to you about Pamela.
Who is it?
It's a friend of mine. Where is she?
Harry, cool it. Look, we just want to know where we can find Pamela.
You can't.
Why don't you just tell us where she is before we get nasty?
Now, you don't get nasty. I do. Now, piss off!
Okay, Kenny. Calm down. Harry, leave it.
Come on then, Kenny.
Harry?
Yeah, come on. Come on.
For God's sake, Harry!
Come on, Kenny. Come on.
Yeah, you go easy on that, Harry. It's my bill.
Oh. You're on expenses anyway, ain't you?
This feels kinky.
You got a bloody awful pimp, Pamela.
Tell me about it.
Hi, Kate, it's me. No, still in Brighton. I'm sorry.
How long have you been on the game?
Why did you leave the police?
It's proven more complicated than I'd thought.
Temperamental differences with my boss.
I thought she was your boss.
Nah.
We're on to something, Harry and me. No, Harry's just helping. We're in the hotel with the lead and I'll be back tomorrow. Is that all right?
You must meet an awful lot of interesting people, eh?
I could keep the news of the screws in business for a year.
I better go. Yeah, I love you too. Night-night. You met some Irishman here in Brighton before the shootings?
2 years ago.
Yeah. Well, one Irishman.
Was he one of the terrorists who were shot by the SAS?
No. I did see one of them. Seamus Kelly. He had his face in the papers afterwards.
Where did you see him?
With Danny. The Irishman I knew.
Danny?
Danny McLaughlin. He was really nice.
And you saw Seamus Kelly with McLaughlin?
Yeah. A night or two before.
So, where's McLaughlin now then?
I don't know. Disappeared after the shootings. I never saw him again.
Did you know him well?
I thought it was something different with him. I saw him for 2 weeks. Said he was here on business. And then he just pissed off. Bastard.
Was his business with Seamus Kelly?
I don't know. I didn't know who Kelly was till afterwards. I asked Danny who he was, but he accused me of spying on him.
What did you tell the police about him?
Didn't tell them about Danny. Didn't want to get him into trouble. And you tell the police as little as possible, right?
Hmm. You didn't think that Danny might be involved in something?
I didn't know much about him.
Oh, come on, Pamela. If he had business with Kelly, he'd have had a good reason for disappearing. He might even have been responsible for their deaths.
But he couldn't have killed them. It was the army did that, wasn't it? Not Danny.
I hope you've been running up expenses, Harry. Right then, tell me all about it.
I don't want you thinking this is setting the pace for the future. Harry and you are only helping me out because this job's got too big for one person.
Sure. Whatever you say.
Okay. I was hired by Sarah Teal to have a word with PC Barrett to see if he'd talk about the Brighton shootings on TV. He put us on to Pamela Hewitt, and Sarah said to chase that up, which Harry and I have done. Now there's the McLaughlin lead, and the question's, is he IRA, and can we find him? But if Sarah wants us to go after McLaughlin, we'll have to renegotiate the contract first.
Fine. So we talk to Ms. Teal?
I'll have a word with Deacon.
Deacon?
Branch have been dropping some heavy hints about the shootings, and we reckon he'll know what they're up to.
Well, there you are. Right, let's get to work.
Never heard of him. The prosy says that he met Kelly 2 nights before the Glory Boys gunned him down.
So, Kelly had a contact in Brighton. Where's Maureen?
Oh, she's bringing Tony up to speed.
You're the one who was on Special Branch, Harry. What's Tony got to do with it?
Well, it might help to speed things up. Matt's got a TV deadline. Tracking down a person who's been missing for Brighton 2 years isn't exactly going to be a pushover, is it? Especially if McLaughlin's IRA.
You don't know that he is. Kelly Ryan and Fitzpatrick may have been described as IRA, but there were no salutes fired over their coffins. You try it and eat, Harry.
Maureen? Sarah.
Hi. This is Tony Clark.
Hello.
We used to work together and I've asked him to help me out on this.
They used to say the Polish police always went round in threes. One who could read, one who could write, and one to watch over the two intellectuals.
So, you found the prostitute?
Yes, she was involved with a man she knew as Daniel McLaughlin. We think he was Seamus Kelly's contact. He met Kelly before the shootings, then disappeared.
IRA?
We assume so.
But that's fantastic. If Kelly had a contact down there, we've got to find him.
I'll give you the address for Seamus Kelly's widow in Kilburn. Maybe she can shed some light on who and where this McLaughlin is.
With respect, we don't know what we're getting into here. If McLaughlin is IRA, or we're supposing we find him, I don't think he's going to be very forthcoming.
I'm making a programme about the SAS shootings in Brighton. If McLaughlin was Kelly's contact, I need him.
Fine. Look him up in the phone book, then.
I'm sorry, what was your name again?
Tony Clark.
Do you believe in rule of law, Tony?
Do I what?
Or do you believe in extrajudicial executions on the streets of Britain?
No, but then I don't believe in letting bombs go off either.
What bomb? The van that Kelly drove into Brighton may have been loaded with Semtex, but there were no detonators found either in the van or in Ryan's car.
They were IRA. Now they're dead. No documentary is going to bring them back. And what are you alleging, anyway, that the SAS killed people? May as well allege that the police wear blue serge.
My program's not biased towards the IRA. I find their actions repellent. But I also find it very worrying that MI5 and the SAS can go around blowing people's heads off without any kind of public inquiry.
Yeah, I do actually have some experience of the security services, Miss Teal. I also know a bit about terrorism, and just sitting here in your ionized office making programs about shoot to kill strikes me as very safe and very naive.
I know quite a bit myself, Tony. I can't even dial a pizza without someone at BT taking notes on my choice of toppings. If you're not up to finding McLaughlin, then I'll find someone who is. I've got lunch with a junior minister from the Home Office. If there's anything else to be got out of that prostitute, I ought to come down with you, see what she'd be like on camera.
Well done.
Well, she really expects you to go after this guy?
Yes. You go and use your colossal charm on Mary Kelly.
There's a documentary series being made, suggestions of shoot-to-kill policy. The name McLaughlin has cropped up.
Has it indeed?
I drew a blank with Branch.
No surprises there.
I thought maybe you could enlighten me.
No can do, John.
Well, you don't know of him.
John, to all intents and purposes, McLaughlin has ceased to exist. We'd rather keep it that way.
Do I take that as meaning whoever finds him becomes an embarrassment?
Seems so long ago, doesn't it? The Reds, the wall. Such a pity one has to move with the times.
So how'd it go? Tony and Sarah got on like a house on fire.
Tony, is he in on this?
I'm afraid so.
So just like the old days, then, eh?
Well, no. I'm the boss. But he is lousing up my chances of working with Sarah again. Harry, it's Mo. Could you ring the hotel and find out if they have any record of McLaughlin staying there? Yeah, just pretend you're McLaughlin and you need a new receipt for tax purposes. Thanks.
So what's she like, this Sarah Teal?
Well, she's great. She's on the level.
That's she before we left Belfast. I was pregnant with Roisin then. He had a cousin in the Mayors. We just wanted to get away from the troubles.
But he'd never got involved in terrorism before Brighton.
An old school friend of his got shot by the UDR, but I never thought she was involved. I couldn't believe it when the police came. I thought he was at his work.
You ever mentioned a man called McLaughlin?
Danny McLaughlin?
No.
Did he have any Republican friends?
Well, they'd cheer when another soldier got killed, but they'd never left a gun themselves. Too drunk most of the time.
Before Brighton, do you remember him meeting anyone, talking about anyone, anyone who wasn't in his normal circle of friends?
Well, they were all taproom freedom fighters. She took collections, he sang songs with the rest of them when he'd had a few. God knows how many people he talked to.
Anyone who might have persuaded him to help set up a bomb?
Look, I don't know how he got involved or why he was murdered. All I know is that he is dead and I'm bringing up his daughter on my own.
But if Shay's little plan had succeeded, there'd have been an awful lot of orphans around this place, wouldn't there?
I'm telling you, Shay wasn't one of the boys.
So who set him up?
Well, if I knew that, I'd have killed them with my own bare hands. It was the government and the army murdered my husband. That is all I know.
As far as HMG is concerned, the timing of your documentary seems to be a little unfelicitous. That's the price of freedom of speech, isn't it?
It's one in a series, Jeremy. We're not just investigating dirty tricks and shoot to kill against Irish republicanism.
Well, shoot to kill? It's a bit of a cliché, don't you think? Next to fuel to scorch her?
So the British government has never authorised a clandestine shoot to kill policy?
Can you name me one country which hasn't? Well, Iceland, maybe. But they only have the trolls to worry about. We have fanatics, killers, bombers, you name it. Of course we've had shoot to kill. How else do you expect us to deal with these people?
You're saying that the law doesn't apply to everyone.
Oh, in an ideal world, perhaps. And the beauty of the SAS is that they kill the people you want dead without you having to tell them to. Privatize them, you'd have the best rent-a-kill in the business. You know, most of us in government have fantasies about SAS and Five, which border on the sexual. Don't you?
You're openly admitting that the government wanted Fitzpatrick, Ryan and Kelly executed in broad daylight.
All I'm saying, Sarah, strictly entre nous, is that I was far happier seeing those three blown away than climbing into my Brighton hotel bed with a nice hot parliamentary researcher only to experience the earth moving for all the wrong reasons.
Shall I do another one, then, sir?
No, we wouldn't want to exhaust you.
No, don't worry, I could go on all night.
Not with a bayonet through your neck, you.
This one is called The German Guns.
I know.
Spiffy, yes, let's hear that.
Oh, Pamela, hi.
Boom, 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 boom. Boom.
Well, does it have to be tonight?
Boom.
Yeah, okay, okay. I'll be there. I'm going to have to go. It's the prostitute.
When will you be back?
I think that'll rather depend on Sarah.
All right, Ulrich, for old time's sake.
How are you doing for money? Do you need another advance?
I might do now that I'm sharing it with the boys. Look, I feel I ought to apologise for Tony. He shouldn't have said what he did.
Don't worry about it. The mouth's usually a few steps ahead of the brain in cases like that. How long are you working with him?
3 years.
Must have driven you up the wall.
We had our moments.
Poor you. I suppose I should feel sorry for his wife.
No, no wife. Not anymore.
Oh.
Right. Well, this time? Yeah. Well, I'm sorry, Kate. I thought she'd have told you at least. Yeah. Bye.
She said she was being followed. She's scared.
Sorry. It's my fault we're late.
She would have waited.
Well, Kate probably blames us for Mo losing her job, getting into bed with us.
Metaphorically speaking. You drinking that?
No, yeah. It's her shag, I've let her on it.
We were worried about you.
I couldn't hang around by the gardens. They were watching. They'd have seen you.
Who was following you?
I don't know. A man. Doesn't that go with the job? You didn't say you were bringing anyone with you.
I'm sorry. This is Sarah Teal. I'm producing this documentary. We're really grateful that you want to speak to us.
Why'd you need that?
Jogs my aging memory. You don't mind, do you? Okay. You rang Maureen this evening. Apparently you have something to tell us. I know that you've already told Maureen about Danny McLaughlin and Seamus Kelly. Could you tell me that?
There's nothing to say.
Do you have anything to tell us?
No, not tonight.
Should we book a couple of rooms? I don't think she'll talk with me here. Well, I better get back. I've got an early edit. Can you stay?
Yeah.
Great. See if you can get anything out of her tomorrow.
Right.
Apologies.
No, it's my night. Morning.
Yeah, I went down to Brighton last night and didn't get much sleep. And my edit started late.
Brighton with Mo?
Yeah.
There you go.
Tony. I know my phone's tapped, but couldn't we have a little chat in my office? Cloak and daggers for overgrown schoolboys.
I'm just being informal. And what I really wanted to say was that, well, we didn't get off to a very good start, did we?
But you went to see Mary Kelly. That's a start, isn't it?
It was something your friend said about how Danny was involved in the deaths. I knew he'd met one of them. I'd never really thought he might have put him up to it.
You never suspected he might be IRA?
I don't think of the IRA as people. They're animals. Sick. And he wasn't. He was nice. Look, I did lie to you a bit. Danny said he was moving out of London. He was looking for somewhere quiet. He promised he'd write to me, he never did. But I know where he is.
You do? Where?
A place called New End Farm in Minster.
How did you find that out?
Someone rang up. I listened in on the extension in the loo. It was the only time we did it in his hotel room. But he always used to say, no hard feelings.
We might be overlooking something here. MI5 ran the anti-terrorist operation in Brighton, and their information about Kelly et al. Never reached Special Branch.
So?
So if McLaughlin was Kelly's contact, who's to say he's IRA? It might have been MI5.
An informant?
Sinn Féin's press spokesman insists those three weren't IRA. They've continually denied it, but no one cares. Sarah Teal? Maureen? You spoke to her, brilliant.
What, I'm just having a coffee with Tony. I'll pass you over to him.
Hello, Mo.
Nice lunch?
Yeah.
What are you doing?
Just comparing notes.
I know where he is.
Whereabouts?
New End Farm.
Hang on. All right, far away.
New End Farm, Minstead.
I hope you're not making things worse.
Well, thanks, Mum. Yeah, I'll get on to it.
Look, don't bust a gut on my account, but if you do find him, tell him Pamela said no hard feelings.
Okay, yeah. Bye. New Forest.
You're going down there?
Of course.
But we don't actually know for sure whose side he's on.
Exactly. Someone's got to find out.
Well, take care of yourself.
Don't worry. I always do.
Who are you?
Tony Clark. I work for a TV company.
What are you doing in my house?
I was sent here to talk to you. I'm a researcher.
Lie down.
What?
Lie down. Who sent you?
My producer, Sarah Teal. There's a card in the wallet, a number's on it.
Why?
We're making a documentary.
How did you find this place?
Pamela said you'd be here. Pamela Hewitt from Brighton.
And what does she want?
Sends her love.
What's she looking like these days?
All right. She said she wanted you to know no hard feelings.
Get up. It's safer out here.
Ah.
So what are you doing here?
I'll ask you about the Brighton shootings 2 years ago.
What makes you think I had anything to do with that?
Pamela Hewitt says she saw you with Kelly a couple of days before, and we know that the SAS seemed very well informed of their whereabouts. Were you Kelly's IRA handler?
That's what Kelly thought I was, and Five weren't about to disabuse him.
You're an informant for Five? Were any of you IRA?
Fitzpatrick was. Green Book General Order Number 2 says any volunteer carrying out an unofficial operation is automatically dismissed. Of course, he didn't realize it wasn't sanctioned by the IRA.
Ryan and Kelly?
Nah. They were just sympathizers. Kelly was a romantic. They'd shot a friend of his in the Murph. He thought he was making a gesture.
You set up three men to be shot by the SAS.
Something like that.
That's not the role of an informant.
I never knew they'd get shot.
Are you prepared to say that on camera? They could hardly bump you off once you'd gone public.
If I did, you'd have to get me money and somewhere to live.
They still keeping tabs on you?
I don't know. I don't know if this place is bugged or not. I don't know who I am or what I'm doing anymore.
You were right, he works for Five. He's prepared to talk, but not here. Yep, Sarah, the deal is you've got to take care of him at least till the program goes out.
You're late.
Well, you got a deal.
You okay?
Yeah.
Why did Five set up three people when sooner or later someone was going to realize it was a hoax?
Because it's war. I'm not talking about terrorism. I'm talking about Branch, Five, Six, all plotting against each other. Turf battles, a great propaganda piss take. Five wanted publicity, wanted to make Special Branch look like a bunch of tossers. I was told to engineer an incident. High profile, political points. It wasn't just the government came out smelling the roses. They turned off the road.
What?
I don't know what your program's dug up, but you can bet your arse Five is taking an interest. They might be following us. Now turn off.
Okay, okay.
You flagged down a vehicle.
Don't go for a core. I'll keep out of sight till you've got the lift.
Mate.
Yeah, sure, we'll get in the bag, yeah? Nice one. After you. Do you want a beer?
No, thanks.
Yeah, why not? Just help yourselves, yeah? We're the Runs.
The what?
The Runs. We started out as a Trotskyist, but it was too big for the poster. Then we reformed as the Trots, then the Runs. I'm Stevie. This is Rob.
Hello.
Sid and Vicky. That's Gordy at the back there. He's not really with us.
I'm Tony.
Danny.
Danny boy. So listen, how come you're wandering around in the middle of the night?
We're on the run from MI5.
Way to go!
How'd you get into all this?
I was an idealist. I could see my country being destroyed. I wanted to do something about it.
So you joined 5?
I had a good life back there in Belfast, you know. Joining 5 seemed like a way of fighting for that. I'm 28. I haven't seen my family for 7 years.
Was it worth it?
Yeah, I knew I had to fight. Trouble was, in the end, I didn't know who I was fighting.
How much did they pay you?
250 thai.
Jesus Christ.
Never stop coming up, guys. Munchies, wee-wees, whatever takes your fancy.
I told Sarah I'd phone to find out where we should meet. You coming?
No, I'm staying here at a site. Don't tell her where we are.
She'd never believe us.
Yeah, I'm sorry to wake you up. I've got him. We're on the road.
Everything okay?
Yeah, fine. We're in good company.
We'll just get him here in one piece. And yourself.
No problems.
I did hear a rumour that 5 were more involved in the Brighton shootings than mere intelligence gathering would warrant. McLaughlin was probably a liability even before you went crashing in.
But you could only know that from Branch. Branch hired you to leak information to Teal, didn't they? And you recommended a newly available police officer who just happened to be a woman.
Oh.
Mo is just going to whoop for joy when she finds out you're behind this.
And there was me thinking you did want to work with Maureen again.
I'd keep quiet about it if I were you.
How did Five know I was on at McLaughlin?
I told them. I apologize.
You piece of shit.
I didn't know McLaughlin was Five's property. If you hadn't blundered in, he'd still be alive.
If you hadn't told them, he'd still be alive. I mean, what is this? They're going around planting bombs now?
Five? Why should they? The IRA wanted him too, you know?
Shoot to kill is a media fallacy. It hasn't happened. It won't happen. It's a myth. The actions of the SAS were wholly appropriate and fully in accordance with the law. And to claim otherwise, in the midst of the current peace process, is both sensationalist and irresponsible.
What if I told you that there was a witness who stated that the entire operation was set up by the security services for propaganda purposes?
I doubt very much you could find such a witness. Your statement has no credibility whatsoever.
And we're left with bugger all.
Well, thanks for your help, everyone.
Pity we couldn't finish the job off.
I'm just grateful you're all still here. Thanks, Harry. You should take more care of yourself.
Bit out of practice.
You were great. Can I call on you again?
Anytime.
Well, I'm for a drink. Anyone else?
Mo's buying.
No, not this time. I just want to get home.
Kate, all right now, then?
How do you mean?
Nothing.
No, what?
Well, she just seemed a bit stressed out the other night. Just a bit.
What night?
When you and Sarah were in Brighton.
Is that supposed to mean something?
No.
You think I slept with Sarah in Brighton?
Well, me and Harry just thought...
Right, no, leave me out of it, Harlan.
I know you find it hard to imagine that a relationship can be both faithful and sexually fulfilling, but I wouldn't have thought you found it that hard to recognise people's sexual orientation. Sarah isn't gay. For reasons which I find totally incomprehensible, she seems to have taken rather a shine to you.